Another note from Brer Caleb, Ph.D. Deception Protocol Simplified. Tough times never last, tough people do. Desperate Zionist move to start WWIII backfires drastically, by Benjamin Fulford comments. The US murder of top Iranian General Qasem Soleimani was a brilliant chess move, or a foolish mistake, but either way, it has severely harmed the Zionists. The martyrdom of Soleimani may have been a brilliant chess move by US President Donald Trump to unleash global anti-Semitism and terminate Israel, Saudi Arabia, Zionism, Exxon, and the deep state using Iran, Russia, China, Turkey, the EU, and its allies, was how one Pentagon source summed up the situation. However, British intelligence got a very different story from their US counterparts, who told them they killed Soleimani because he was going to set off nuclear weapons in an attempt to start WWIII and bring on the Mahdi or Messiah. The British don't believe this excuse and note that it was highly unusual the Pentagon did not forewarn Great Britain, according to MI6 sources. Regardless, despite the incredible Zionist beating of war drums, the Pentagon, Russian, and Chinese sources agree this incident may not escalate into WWIII. As Einstein said, I know not with what weapons they fight World War III, but they will fight World War IV will with sticks and stones. We need to make sure the Iran situation does not threaten modern civilization, was how an Asian secret society source described China's view of this engineered crisis. Quote, dot, dot, dot. Eliminating officials of another UN member state blatantly violates the principles of international law and should be condemned, was Russian Foreign Minister Sergei Lavrov's response to the incident. The world community will support Iranian war crime charges against Trump, and he will eventually end up in jail for this crime, Russian FSB sources promise. Veterans Today is reporting that the US government committed a war crime by officially inviting Soleimani, under the promise of diplomatic immunity and the lifting of sanctions on Iran, only to ambush and kill him. Pentagon sources say that because Trump was tricked into ordering the hit on Soleimani with false Israeli intelligence, he now has a cause and may fire. Zionist agents, Secretary of State Mike Pompeo, Defense Secretary Mark Esper, CIA head Gina Haspel, and even Ivanka, Jared Kushner and Ivanka Trump. The red flag of jihad has been declared on Israel and Saudi Arabia as Iran was cases bellyant global approval, while Trump has political cover to pull US troops and US citizens out of harm's way, the sources say. Also, U.S. Special forces may even hunt Israelis in Kurdish Iraq, Syria, or elsewhere before leaving, and may execute International Criminal Court arrest warrants on Israeli war criminals, the sources predict. As sealed indictments approach the biblical number of 144,000, kinetic warfare may be combined with lawfare through the ICC and military tribunals to wage total war against the Zionists, they continue. The ICC may also prosecute Israel and Saudi Arabia for war crimes in Yemen, crimes against humanity in Syria, Iraq, and Libya, and any Zionists or deep state agents aiding or abetting ISIS-Daesh, they say. The Zionists may have made this desperate attempt to start a war against Iran because of the dragnet closing in on them. For example, the evidence is appearing in the mainstream press. They faked chemical weapons attacks on Syria by the Zionist-controlled Organization for the Prohibition of Chemical Weapons. It means their information controlled the attempt to start WWIII with Iran is connected to the ongoing bankruptcy negotiations of the US corporation, agree with various secret society sources. So far, the U.S. corporation has not found funding to continue its operations past January 31st, and that may be the real reason they played their war card yet again, one Asian secret society source noted. The media hysteria over Iran has distracted people from the fact that the U.S. economy is in a free fall worse than the Lehman crisis of 2008. Here are a few recent signs of this. The Baltic Dry Index has plunged 64% in the past 3 months as the world stops trading with the US grid is collapsing. The US used truck prices fell 50% year-on-year in December, while rail freight dropped 11.5%. It isn't just the automobile industry that, globally, has been mired in recession. We have also noted the stunning collapse in heavy-duty trucking orders over the last 18 months, as the industry continues to deal with the consequences of aggressive over-ordering in 2018 and a domestic economy that merely isn't supporting growth Class 8 trucks like it once did. For instance, we reported just 2 weeks ago that the trucking company Navistar had cut over 1,300 jobs. And after several months of analysts suggesting that trends could be improving and that the worst may be over, the reality for heavy-duty trucking seems to remain that the industry is still grinding slower. Wells Fargo analyst Andrew Casey released a note on Thursday morning suggesting that truck demand conditions remain weak and that pricing is deteriorating for used trucks. Casey believes that most truckers will continue to avoid investing in new vehicles due to transport overcapacity versus relatively low freight demand and pressure on trade-in values.